Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning everybody.
Good morning sir.
How are you today?
I'm fine, thank you. And you?
I'm fine too, thanks. Nice. Okay, please be led to pray.
Attention please. Before we study, let's pray together. Pray begins. Finish.
Okay, thank you, Dava. On this day, we will study about tissue implants. Do you already know about tissue implants?
I don't know, sir. Tidak tahu, Pak.
Good. Because if you already know, I will not teach. So, terdapat tiga jaringan tumbuhan at the tissue level. Yaitu ada dermal tissue to protect organ. Dermal tissue serve as the outer protective covering on the plane. Like our skin, it forms the first line of defense against physical damage and pathogen. In non-woody plants, it is usually a single tissue called the epidermis, a layer of tightly packed cell. In leaf and moss stems, the cuticle wax epidermal coating help prevent water loss. In woody plants, protective tissue called periderm replace the epiderm in older region of stem and roots. In addition to protect the plant from water loss and disease, the epidermis has special characteristic in each organ. In roots, water and mineral absorb from the soil and through the epidermis. Especially in root hairs, in such special epidermal cell called guard cell are involved in gaseous exchange. Another class of highly special epidermal cell found in shoot consists of outgrowth called trichome. Highlight trichomes reduce water loss and reflect excess light. Some trichomes defend against insect. Through saps that hinder movement or gland that secrete sticky fluids or toxic compound. Then vascular tissue to provide support and transfer resources. The two major functions of vascular tissue are to facilitate the transport of material throughout the plant and to provide mechanical support. Vascular tissue are two types, xylem and phloem. Xylem conduct water and dissolve mineral upward from root into the roots. Phloem transport sugars, the product of photosynthesis, from where they are met, usually the leaf, to where they are needed or stored, usually roots and sites of growth, such as developing leaves and fruits. The vascular tissue are of a root or stem is collective called the stele. The arrangement of the stele first depending on the species and organ. In angiosperms, for example, the root stele is a solid center vascular cylinder of xylem and phloem, whereas the stele of stems and leaf consists of vascular bundles, spread strands containing xylem and phloem. But xylem and phloem are composed of a variety of cell types, include cells that are highly specialized for transport or support, and then ground tissue includes cells that carry out photosynthesis and store sugar. Tissue that is neither dermal nor vascular is ground tissue. Ground tissue that is internal to the vascular tissue is known as peat, and ground tissue that is external to the vascular tissue is called cortex. Ground tissue is not just filler. It includes cell specialist four functions such as storage, photosynthesis, support, and short distance transport. Oke, baik. Sampai di sini, adakah yang ingin bertanya?
Saya izin bertanya, Pak.
Ya, silakan, Said.
Disebutkan oleh Bapak tadi, jaringan dasar yang berada di dalam jaringan vaskular disebut pit atau empelur. Sedangkan yang berada di luar jaringan vaskular disebut korteks. Pertanyaannya, apakah pit dan korteks ini mempunyai fungsi yang sama dalam jaringan dasar as a storage, photosynthesis, support, and short distance transport? Apa begitu, Pak?
Ya, mungkin dari teman-teman ada yang ingin coba menjawab?
Saya izin mencoba menjawab, Pak. Karena mereka berasal dari ground tissue atau jaringan dasar. Menurut saya sama, Pak.
Pak, saya sepakat dengan Bayu. Jadi, hanya posisinya saja yang berbeda. Yang mana pit atau empelur di zona internal vascular tissue. Sedangkan korteks di zona eksternal vascular tissue.
Ya, betul Bayu dan Dova. Jawabannya sangat saling melengkapi nih. Jadi jaringan dasar ini bukan hanya sekedar pajangan saja, tapi dia juga berfungsi untuk sebagai penyimpan cadangan makanan, fotosintesis, dan juga transportasi jarak pendek. Nah, sampai di sini, ada lagi yang ingin bertanya?
Dari saya cukup, Pak.
Kalau dari saya juga cukup, Pak.
Baik, kalau tidak ada lagi yang ingin bertanya, saya cukupkan untuk materi pengantar jaringan tumbuhan pada hari ini. Untuk yang lebih dalamnya, untuk lebih detailnya lagi, kita akan bahas di pertemuan berikutnya. Dikarenakan waktunya yang sudah tidak mencukupkan pada hari ini, saya akhiri dengan mengucapkan Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan selamat sore.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Selamat sore juga, Pak. Terima kasih, Pak.